that is the way it all began in the Fillmore East in New York City with my marvelous young, my teens, when we started taking trips. Do you hear me? Trips with the greatest navigator of all sound, Johann Sebastian Bach. When I say trips, I mean to tell you that this is the kind of a trip where there is bright sunlight, magnificent uplift, true inspiration. And I'm very happy to tell you that I continue this tradition right across this country out into the winterland of San Francisco, and where at that point I played for the gang, the Jig Fugue. I assured them that the tune comes first in the tenor, second in the alto, third in the soprano. And when it hits the bass in my feet, I dance the jig. When those kids heard that pedal tune come in, 6,000 hands came together. Do you feel up to it? Okay. When it hits the feet, and mind you, I heard a swishing in the hall, and I turned around, and where they had been seated upon blankets, they kicked their blankets aside, and at the end of this piece, there were 400 young doing a divine jig to a fugue of Bach. Let's do it.
Have you ever heard two brass bands playing two different tunes at one and the same moment? Charles Ives, American composer, also at the turn of the century, heard precisely this on a holiday in a small Connecticut village where there was just one main street and these two bands not knowing about each other. And when they came together, the sound was terrible. He, however, was intrigued. In all of his compositions, he has these unrelated harmonic structures, one on top of the other. And in the variations on My Country 'Tis of Thee that I'm going to play for you now, there are devices where I'm playing at one and the same time, the same tune in one flat in one hand and in five flats in the other. Charles Ives was very annoyed about themes and variations. And when he wrote this piece, I am sure he meant it to be a great big travesty on the idea. And if you listen to this with a long face, you'll be in the wrong pew. At the beginning of the piece, he makes an introduction that is a very much tongue-in-cheek affair. Listen for the innuendo as to what's going to take place. He plays the tune immediately after the introduction, just as straight-laced as can be, without any emotion. First variation sounds like Jenny Lind singing, "Lo, hear the gentle lark." Second variation is a chromatic squeeze. Third variation sounds like an actress casting out rose petals from a swing. In the fourth variation, if you've never heard My Country 'Tis of Thee played in a rumba tango rhythm in the minor key, watch out. For the fifth and final variation, he puts instructions for the player on the music. And it says in plain language, hold on to the bench with one hand and pedal it just as fast as it'll go. So will you now please fasten your seat belts for the Variations on My Country 'Tis of Thee by Charles Ives.
universal mind, an overwhelming heart, and a transcendental spirit. And you can't beat that. Once you've had a view of Bach, you never again will be the same.
As if all the music in the world could possibly be lined up on this side, and then Bach, the greatest composer of all, stuck over here in some kind of a glass case in a museum under dust next to a comb that some dead queen wore in her hair 3,000 years ago? Not on your life. The sermon is over. We're about to start with the real thing. I don't talk about it. I propose to get on that machine and do it.
There's no point in standing around being modest about it. I'm not modest. I know that I can do the thing that I tell them I'm going to do. And I sit down and jolly well do it. It is a trip, and the difference between my trip and anybody else's is that I come out clean.